Hi guys, welcome back to more episodes of Ozark. We're on to Season 3, Episode 3. So in the last one, Helen and Wendy successfully railroaded the old couple with their casino into selling, despite Marty's real attempts to try and circumvent it, because he felt it was a bad idea. He didn't exactly say any details as to why. However, even though we got the Kansas City mob involved to try and stop this happening, it didn't work. So, we end the episode with the FBI turning up and going, now you're going to be investigated completely because you have just opened a second casino. Which is precisely what he was actually talking about. So, they haven't listened. They've been short-sighted with it. And Marty's been proven right, at least with this. So, let's go see what happens. This is episode 3.
You know, actually, it'd be a huge help if you could deal with the REO Speedwagon people. Person. His name's Dickie.
Ugly as we left her.
No one will be fired. In fact, you will continue to be paid. And when you come back, you will return to a more sophisticated and healthier work environment. I have no use for a hotel with no casino.
You'll lose a fortune if you shut down. Especially during the summer months.
They don't care.
We are bigger than you, and we are meaner, and we do not lose. So,
off you pop.
Why don't you just sell us the hotel? I'm done with it.
Agent Maya Miller.
Marty Bird.
So, show me around the place.
Gotta play along.
I have a team of forensic accountants deployed at the tables, creating a rough estimate of your physical chip counts. NWA.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we'll compare those counts to your receipts every hour and also check your cash.
Oh,
prices.
My God.
But I need hard data.
She's the numbers girl.
There's suddenly a massive jump in revenue, well, that's cause for a new warrant.
Oh my God.
We start this dance all over again.
The new FBI agent, she's good. I don't know how we're going to be able to move money through here.
Yeah.
That's what you want to tell me? That's why he called me up here?
I need you to get Frank Jr. and his guys to smurf this week's run into the new casino.
Wendy says the new place is supposed to be clean.
She doesn't need to know.
Great fucking job communicating with your wife.
Yep.
She closed the fucking casino.
What are you talking about?
Fucking deserted and chained up.
Ruth, let me talk to you when you get here, please.
Just get your fucking shit together, Marty.
Are your husband around?
He is not.
Yeah, you'll have to do that. You shut down the new casino. We're supposed to start the roots this week.
Yeah.
I'm sorry?
But you're not communicating. It's like they're opposite sides. It's like they're enemies competing against one another right now. And the leaving, in particular Marty, more so than normal, you're leaving loose ends. He's just allowed the fact that because Helen doesn't know, Wendy doesn't know what he did and who he involved, you've got Kansas City mob boss waltzing right up here to discuss it.
How did you know the casino was closed?
The blonde, Curly Sue. She had my boy's crew.
Curly Sue.
Something about moving money.
Do you not see a pattern here? You have done nothing but fight me on this. And now you want unfettered access to the very thing you've tried to undermine since the very beginning. I don't think we want to annoy our shareholders.
What would you have me do?
I don't feel very compelled to help you.
She's like, I don't want to get involved in this.
With Frank.
Please do not get us further in on this.
And because you didn't get your way, you went behind my back to sabotage me.
I was trying to protect our family,
Uh-oh.
Wendy. That's it.
That is such a tired
excuse. Oh, fuck's sake.
A marriage is only as good as its trust. Going behind Wendy's back on a project that is obviously meaningful to her violates that trust.
What the hell was that? Hey, Sue, what the hell was that?
You said let her have one.
You told me to let her win a couple.
You did.
Small things. Small.
There is something deeper at play here. And
you've
I
no idea.
Wendy can be happy.
Oh.
You've trusted me so far.
I don't trust you. I trust my opinion of you. Well, if you can't get what you want with reason, then...
Yes. Force.
You have to get it with force.
Yeah.
We need to look for a short-term solution for our laundering problems.
And I am telling you, as his attorney, my client wants this new business clean.
Listen, the only reason we can't move any money through the Missouri bill right now is because of an audit that she brought down on us. Okay? Maybe she should talk to Navarro.
No.
It's a long time.
And for how many of those 44 years has she made you feel insignificant?
44 of them.
No, look, I used to stay at home. I did.
He told me my desires had taken a back seat to my wife's for too long. He's the reason I pulled out of our deal.
You're facing financial ruin. Now, you've got to get your wife to do the right thing here. Otherwise, she's going to lord this over you your entire life. Now, you're a smart man. She might not be able to see that, but I can.
All right.
I'm impressed with your skills. I'm impressed with your loyalty. Now, because of this new casino, Marty may have increased responsibilities. Could you run the day-to-day at the Missouri Bell if Marty were away?
Uh-oh, shit.
Yeah, I could do that.
What do you mean by that?
I was hoping.
Hey, Sheriff Nix, it's Jonah Byrd.
Oh, hey, Jonah. I didn't recognize you there. All right, Uncle Ben, you want to just slow it down just a little bit for me there?
We will.
Okay?
Okay.
All right.
You're an absolutely terrible sheriff.
What just happened here?
An understanding.
What are you talking about?
Helen came over to my place to see if I can help.
She hasn't discussed it.
Because they're going to need you over there.
What did you tell her?
That I could do. The fuck you think I told her?
Just got to figure out a way to keep on wandering.
Yeah. Between Helen and Wendy and Navarro... kind of on Wendy's side. They are bypassing you.
So we can be living out on the street?
To me, you'll be the big burly man, but to those two blonde B-words, you barely have a thing to say.
I should have married your brother. He was 3 inches taller than you.
Okay, so that happened. He's just gonna walk off. Oh, well, that's taken care of. That'll just go home.
Let me recount. You had a baby.
I didn't have a baby.
You had a baby, moved to Missouri. You bought a casino. And apparently the Ozark Boat Police. And then you bought another casino. And...
where's all the money come
you
from?
You and Marty are doing really great.
Well, that's how it appears.
Marty wants me to leave.
Oh, he doesn't want you to leave.
No, he does.
He told me to leave.
Okay, well, yeah, he wants you to leave. I'm going to pick a fist fight with a hillbilly.
You're serious?
Mm-hmm.
With a very scary hillbilly.
I don't give a fuck what Marty thinks.
Ooh.
Dickie, would it mitigate any of those nerves if we did an extra $100,000? Will that make things better? Please do.
Yeah, give me a minute here.
And if it's helpful, you know, same vendor could handle the merchandise for you guys, if it's helpful.
We've bought a new casino, and we're ready to cut you in a very generous way. I mean, all you have to do is give up your parental rights.
And your baby.
What are you saying to me? I'm offering you money. Best for him. Jacob would
she's
take
gonna
the deal.
Smack
I don't
you.
Ever want to hear you utter
that's
his
what she
name
wants.
Again.
That's what she wants. I'm just figuring it out. Don't.
Deserves better than a farm stand and a redneck for mama.
Precisely what she wanted. I figured it out as it was happening.
That ought to do it.
Yeah, thank you.
There's no one on my team who can do what you do.
You on the other side?
What?
You're offering me a job.
Yeah, that's what it sounds like.
I'm saying if you pled guilty to a separate offense.
Provided you agree to help me catch people like you.
And shut all of this down. Do you know what the authorities don't understand and don't get? You know, they deal with criminals all day long. But when they go, oh, you'll only do a little bit of time and the cartel will think that you didn't squeal, blah, blah, blah. All the shit that she's just said. Would you trust anybody, whoever they are, including the government, the authorities, your partner, your wife, your husband, anyone, to go sit in a jail cell for 18 months and all this goes away? The minute you're in prison, there is nothing they can do or are prepared to do to protect you and stop you being dead within inside of a week because someone decides to shank you because they don't like the look of your face, and it not even have anything to do with why you're in prison in the first place. The minute you're in a prison cell and you are a white-collar person like Marty is, you won't last 5 minutes.
Here's how this is going to play out.
We're on camera, idiot.
We want Marty Bird. We're sure he talked to your boss Kansas City about this job.
Damn, I'll like to get some out of one of these. They're low-key.
If you help us get him, your friends don't have anything to worry about.
You got into your hillbilly fistfight.
I did.
I'm so proud of you.
You won't be when you find out what she does. I had this a lot when I was watching Breaking Bad. I love to watch all of them, but in particular Marty, and now Wendy as well, because she's become a lot more prominent, a lot more involved. How you continue. It's the Walter White syndrome. You continue to justify and make excuses, and oh, it's not my fault, and I was railroaded into it, or I had no other out. You continue to justify all the bad stuff that you've done and all the bad things you've done to people and what you've got involved in, because it's not really anything you control. It's not really your fault, and you're not the bad guy. You are the bad guys. Same as Walter White. You're all bad guys.
What can we do next? Another hotel, another casino?
Are you kidding me?
Or if you have bigger plans,
you're being jerked. These guys
Hello?
Just told
him. There?
Oh shit.
This line is compromised.
Oh shit. He didn't know he should be calling him. He's monitoring. Of course he would be. Now Wendy knows.
Hey, little thought. Why don't you guys come over here?
It's him.
We got booze.
Don't have anything to do with him.
Right.
We think.
Would you mind staying and watching our stuff?
Stupid.
All right, where the fuck are we going? Where the fuck are we going? I don't need to fucking go in there.
No, I know you don't, but you're going in anyway. There's four of them. What's he supposed to think of this? Yeah, they do not want to be followed. Oh shit, no. Oh my god. Right, episode 3. That was an intense episode and all sorts of shit going wrong. I've tried to put a lot of my thoughts and opinions and shock moments into that as much as possible, so I'll keep this fairly short. All through that episode, in particular, the conversation between Ruth and Helen. Can you take care of things if Marty's not going to be around? That's pretty much the gist of that conversation. And it's just played out right at the end there. I don't know whether that is to do with all the crap that's currently going on and nothing to do with the fact that Navarro knew that the call was being traced when Helen rang him. I don't see how he could possibly know that that's Marty. I mean, they're obviously checking to make sure they're not being tapped by the FBI or anyone else. But I have a feeling that is Marty on his way to being put in front of him, which is going to mean out of the country. And Helen knew it was coming. Anyway, so he can't be the phone call, can it? Oh my god. So that's what we're left with. And Wendy's brother has just been witness to it all. Goes and tells Ruth, and you get that with the car just pulling to one side and him, that guy getting out going, do not follow us or you're dead. That guy didn't need to do anything, did he? He was a big belly guy. You just got out with a gun, aimed it at you. That's all you need to know. You don't need to know any more than that. Don't get involved. The next episode. Damn. Where's he going to be? What's going to happen? Just as he's already decided, he feels his time is running out and he's going to try and accept that offer from the FBI woman, the numbers woman from the casino, which I was shocked at. Sometimes you see something coming quite clearly. Sometimes it's a little bit more blurred. He saw enough, as far as he was concerned, to go, 18 months, okay, I'll take it. And within seconds of that happening, there were... Damn. I don't know precisely what Wendy's play is with Darlene, but getting her to punch her in public, obviously, was the primary goal, which is done. I want to see what her next move is to that, to get that kid taken off her, to get Zeke taken off her. Wendy's brother has no idea the absolute huge mound of crap that he's just got himself involved in, but he's just had a taste. Okay, we'll be back with episode 4 next. Don't forget, if you do want to watch this in full length, because they are very long episodes, and there's only so much I can put into an edited version if you only watch this on YouTube. If you want to see the whole thing, anyway, just check the link in the description, and you can head on over to Patreon and watch the full length version over there. While I'm at it, if you've got any comments about this episode, please feel free to post them down below. If you haven't already subscribed, I would appreciate you clicking the button, giving the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. This series is just, you never know what's going to happen. And I need to mention it before I go. The old guy with his wife. That wasn't premeditated whatsoever. That was a guy just going, do you know what? I've had enough shit. For his 44 years of marriage, and he's had Wendy sit him down and going, when are you going to actually go and strap on a bear? And he finally plucks up the courage to go and say something, and his wife ends up rolling down the hill and cracking her head open. I don't know when I'm going to come back to that, but I'm intrigued to. Right, okay, I will see you for episode 4 next. Thanks for watching, guys. Take care.